Hello and welcome to Double Jump Gaming News, your source for college video game news and culture. My name is Sabina Roslowski.
And my name is Justin Benjamin.
Today, we take a look at Nintendo's newest console, the Nintendo Switch, with an unboxing and the first look at one of its bigger name titles, The Legend of Zelda: Breath of the Wild.
But first, let's dive into this week's gaming news.
Xbox One users are getting a feature that might be chipping away at some of the remains of GameStop. VentureBeat noted an 8% decrease in GameStop's stock after Microsoft announced a new Game Pass subscription service. For just $9.99 a month, Xbox One users can enjoy hundreds of titles downloaded directly to their Xbox instead of streamed like Sony's PlayStation Now service. Games will be rotated out and so far span from Xbox One games such as Halo 5 and Gears of War Ultimate Edition, as well as Xbox 360 titles such as Fable 3. Not every game was announced, but make sure you're focused on DoubleJumpGamingNews.com as we learn more. So I have to ask, what are your thoughts on this?
I'm pretty excited for this. I think they're doing a very good response to Sony's PlayStation Now service because I find being able to download the game directly is a lot more reliable than streaming it. And I also find cool that they're doing Xbox 360 games as well, because a lot of players miss being able to do Xbox games or Xbox 360 games on their Xbox One. So that's cool.
Do you see noticeable difference between the Xbox One and what PlayStation Now is doing?
I don't know exactly how Sony's PlayStation Now works, but I believe you have to pay for each individual game instead of doing a monthly subscription.
Okay. I got that. So when it comes to the whole streaming, even if it's a game that is just being streamed, do you have issues that are internet-based, or what is the difference between just streaming it and actually downloading it?
Downloading it, it's on your hard drive, so you don't have to, you're not downloading it, and it's actually on your hard drive, and it's a lot more reliable, in my opinion, than having to stream it. It's just, it's on your hard drive, you know it's there, and something having to, download and stream it.
Okay. Do you think you would actually look into buying something like this, especially if it's only being $9.99?
If I had an Xbox One, yes, I would, but I do not have an Xbox One. Fans of Mass Effect are going to be upset about the recent cancellation of Andromeda's multiplayer beta. Mass Effect Andromeda is still scheduled to launch on March 21st. That's spring break for Whitewater students. Origin users with Origin access can play the multiplayer single-player PC demo on March 16th, where progress will carry over into the real game. So, what are your thoughts on them canceling that?
I'm actually a little bit upset about it. I can't believe that they would cancel multiplayer. Multiplayer is one of the biggest things that people look forward to. They like not only the competition aspect of it, but they genuinely enjoy just getting to play online, getting to get a little, competitive with it. I don't actually know why they canceled it.
Maybe they didn't feel they're prepared enough for it. That's my guess. They didn't feel like they had enough, they didn't think they have enough of their issues quite fleshed out yet. And, they don't want a buggy beta to the point where it's unplayable. So I feel like that's the reason they might have canceled it, but still not happy about it.
See, I really appreciate that though. Companies that actually want to take time to put love into their games and not just give the people who love the games a crappy quality, I really appreciate that they want to make sure that it's good before they actually put out something that could possibly be bad for the name.
I can agree with that, yeah.
No, I'm glad that they're doing it. I just really hope that it wasn't a scrunched for time issue. I really hope it's they're just trying to tweak it, make it a better experience for the players. Overall, I just kind of hope that I really want it to come back. I actually really want to play the multiplayer for it. I would enjoy it.
Three's multiplayer was fun. I'm looking forward to it.
I think it'd be really good. But besides from that, have you actually heard anything about the multiplayer or no?
I believe it's going to be a lot like Mass Effect 3's multiplayer, where it's co-op and it's wave-based survival. And I think the campaign might actually be co-op at this point. I'm not entirely sure. I'm not a huge Mass Effect fan. I don't quite keep up with how it works.
Nintendo is making headlines this week, importantly with the Nintendo Switch's release on March 3rd. And we have an unboxing and first impressions on the Nintendo Switch after the break.
But while you're waiting, be sure to check out our website at DoubleJumpGamingNews.com for more content.
On. Flip them off. 91.7 WSUW. 91.7 is a student-run radio station serving the Whitewater area with a variety of original programs, live sports broadcasting, community events, and more. So turn us on, 91.7 FM, or stream us live at 917theedge.com.
The James R. Conner University Center on UW-Whitewater's campus is a gathering place for students of various cultures, backgrounds, and lifestyles. The UC is a great source for information, campus tickets, meetings, entertainment, food, gallery exhibits, workshops, and all of your hot card needs. Whether you're looking for a place to study between classes or just a place to hang out with friends, the UC is the place for you. For more information on the UC, please visit uc.uww.edu or go to facebook.com/uc.uww.
Double Jump Gaming News, and I'm Sabina Rozlowski, and joining me today is my good friend David Jarris, who has graciously let us unbox his Nintendo Switch. And I am so jealous, because mine's not here today, but he has been nice enough to let us use his.
Yeah, you hadn't got yours yet, and I was like, yeah, you can use mine, and here we go. We're going to unbox it now, right?
I'm really excited for it. So, do you want to open it up first?
Yeah, let's see what's inside. Well, gotta flip it over. Here we go.
Da-na-na-na. Oh, it looks so nice.
First side. Very nice packaging. I like it. What are we going to pull out first?
It's actually, it's a little bit smaller than I thought it would be.
Yeah, you can go ahead and grab the console, see what that looks like. I'm going to take out the controllers and see what they look like first.
These, do you mind if I
open? Go for it, yeah.
Cool.
Here are the controllers. They're kind of small. You can see in comparison to my hands, let's see. Like, pretty big, pretty small. All right.
Wow. Look at this. Just look at how nice this looks. It's like the fresh, just no fingerprints. I love it. I think it's so nice.
Huh. These actually fit in my hand surprisingly well. I do feel like they're kind of big, but doesn't feel too bad.
So for this, you can see, like, especially on the side, where the how the controllers will, like, click into this. It's actually a lot smoother than I thought it would look. Of course, there's the power button up on top. There's the volume up here. Game card you've got over here as well, like power, volume. Underside is like charging ports, such like that. I'm pretty sure this is cooling. I might be wrong, but that looks like cooling up here. This is so cool. I love this. This feels like the DS I always wanted, but like never could get.
Here's this.
Here. Trade me.
I'm just gonna take a quick look. These are so cool.
Oh my goodness. Friends at home, please. Play with these. They're awesome.
Oh, cool.
Like, they're so cool.
Pop that up there. There's the Switch propped up. Let's see what else is in here first. All right. Got some stuff packaged all right. We got an HDMI cable here, power cable. Got the shoulder pads for the controllers.
The wrist straps.
Wrist straps. Wrist straps, not shoulder pads. No shoulder pads.
Whoa.
They got the buttons on there, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's really cool. I actually didn't realize that. I didn't realize that on these they actually have like the little buttons here. Like, do you see these little things? They're adorable. I never even noticed. And they do have a lock for this, so it will not just slide off at one point.
That's very handy. And here's the dock for the controllers if you just want to play it at home. Go ahead.
See that.
Go take a look at it.
So when I initially saw the dock for the controllers, I kind of thought it was going to be a little bit uncomfortable. It's actually not as bad as I thought it was going to be.
Did you slide them in there correctly?
No, I was scared I didn't want to break it. It does fit a little bit better. I just don't want to break it, because if I did, I would just cry inside. But it's actually really nice. It fits really well in your hands. Like, I honestly didn't think it was going to be this nice. I really do enjoy it.
And here's the dock, finally, so the thing you put the Switch in. It's a lot lighter than I thought it was going to be, so it's interesting.
Oh, okay. So, for the... Okay. All right. So well, when it came to, yeah, honestly, I'm actually super excited about these controllers. They look a lot more interesting. Like, they feel so nice. And the thing that I'm most excited about, here, can you take this one, is the fact that you can actually, like, hold it this way, and especially when we were talking about with, like, the multiplayer option. This actually feels really comfortable in your hands. I honestly thought it would feel a little bit, like scrunched, but it feels really nice. And I don't have tiny hands, so I'm really enjoying it. I think it feels really good.
Yeah, first impressions, I'm pretty impressed right now. I can't wait to get in and start playing around with Mario Kart and Breath of the Wild. I can't wait for that. Sit on my couch for hours on end.
Is there anything else in the box or no?
Nope, that was everything. About the dock, the Switch, the controllers, the wrist straps.
So the one thing that I do really like about the Switch is the fact that it did include the little stand up for it. So that if you and your friends wanna actually, or like even when they had like the release trailer, they had people have this in like on airplanes and stuff, so you could put that down, hold the controllers, play. I think it looks really cool. This makes me so excited. I cannot wait to get my hands on my own Switch. I have to wait a little bit longer, but I am so grateful that David was able to bring his for us to unbox it.
More than happy for you guys.
So excited. Honestly, I wasn't sure how the Switch was gonna like fit in the charging dock. I didn't know how it would work so well, but
let's just see.
It's actually it's really compact. It's
adorable.
Yeah, it fits
in there pretty nice.
I really like it.
Small form factor. That's nice. Fit all the cables in through the back, I'm guessing.
Oh yeah.
Oh, look at that.
The back opens up, so you can actually either hide the cables or put more of the cables on the inside. I think that's really convenient. This kind of arcs back to when they had like the Nintendo Wii days, how it was just the very compact little thing that you could put like on the side of your TV. This is really reminiscent of that, and I'm a big fan of that. I think anything that allows you to be compact and yet still has a lot of power behind it is really cool.
I'm actually surprised at how little the dock, I thought the dock was gonna be like, it gives it power or something, but all the power is in the console itself, that little, the tablet part. So that's pretty interesting to me, and all the cables going through the dock.
I actually, to be honest, I didn't think it was gonna be this small. I thought it was gonna be just like a little bit bigger, but especially since they wanna make it like an on-the-go type of console, I think this is actually perfect size. I think this will fit well in someone's bag, in someone's purse. Just throw it in your backpack on the way to school. This is great.
I want to see how it feels with the controllers in the dock, actually.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Slide them in there.
That was the one thing I was worried about. I was kind of wondering if it would be easy. And when I was playing with the controller...
It's pretty easy.
When I was playing with the... Oh, God, that looks so cool. Just look at how cool this looks. This is just... Oh, I want one so bad. When I'm a big button person. So like if the buttons, when I push them down, they don't feel good, I don't enjoy it as much. So for these to actually have a good press to them, but not really make a sound, I'm a big fan.
Yeah, it's got good weight and everything. When you're done, you just slide it back in there. And there we go.
So after the break, we're gonna be playing the much anticipated The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. Thank you for joining us for the unboxing, and we'll be back right after the break.
Here at the University of Wisconsin-Whitewater, we ensure the safety of others. Our CSOs provide a number of services, such as vehicle jump starts, vehicle unlocks, building lockouts, and walking escorts. Do not be afraid to call 472-4660. CSOs, always there to protect and serve.
Education, activism, through creative engagement. PEACE is a nonpartisan organization that promotes peaceful resolutions to university and worldwide conflicts. we raise awareness on issues regarding environmental rights, social equality, and political justice. Every month, we show a documentary in the summer's auditorium. You can learn and have fun doing it. Peace. Be the change you see in the world.
Welcome to Jitters Coffee Lounge. Located on the first floor of the Wells Complex, Jitters is a student-ran, volunteer-based coffee lounge, open nightly from 8 p.m. to midnight. Jitters Coffee Lounge is home to classic hot and frozen drinks with our favorite, the Oreogasm. Jitters offers live music, karaoke, and comedy events featuring both local and guest talents. For more information, visit our website at uwwjitters.org. Jitters Coffee Lounge will keep you up all night.
Welcome back to Double Jump Gaming News. Previously, we were unboxing the new Nintendo Switch, and now we're here with Cody, who recently just got his copy of The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild.
Yeah, so my Switch actually arrived a day early, so I have a little bit of a further distance into the game. So I'm about maybe 8-ish hours into it, where the game actually opens up a little bit, lets you explore a little bit more, so you're not as restricted in, you know, as far as what we can do. So we're just going to do something simple, nothing spoilerly, nothing about the story or anything. I think we're going to probably just show you, like, you know, being able to hunt a little bit and capture a horse and go from there.
That sounds good. Let's get into it.
So, we probably showed this off a little bit earlier, but you can slide the controllers right in. This is called the Joy-Con grip. There's also a charging version of it, so you can just have the controller in there. Unlike, you know, previous game controllers in existence, these things will swap out. I can put this in the tablet or just put it in the grip. If I wanted to, I could hold this like a Wii Remote and Nunchuck, but for Breath of the Wild, they recommend this. It also comes with the unit as well. But let's take a look at the game. Okay. So right here, kind of on the spot here, you can kind of see Link is a little bit, decked out a little. He's got warmer clothes on. He's got a nice bandana going there. I'm really good at really stylizing him, totally. Or it's just whatever the game gives me to. So right here, I'm actually using just the motion controls in order to target that, so makes it sometimes a little bit of a nuisance, but Let's try to get this buffalo here. There he goes. So with this, you're actually able to cook in this game, so I can actually get some raw meat here. It can actually go into a little bit, go into a town or something and start cooking, or sometimes they'll be laying around by a campfire.
Ooh. All right, and I got a good question for you, since you've had a lot more hands-on experience than I have with this game. How similar would you say this is to more of a open-world survival kind of game like Skyrim?
If you've played any Zelda game before, you've never had to worry about your items breaking. Mm-hmm. But as you can see here, this Boku Club here, it's badly damaged. So if I start, playing around with this thing, I can break that like that.
Okay.
And then I have one less weapon at my disposal. Enemies do give you weapons and stuff like that when they drop, but it's a lot more of being resourceful. There's also like different shields. So unlike Skyrim, everything's kind of like in its own menu. You just press the, you go onto the Joy-Con here, you press the D-pad buttons, and they kind of bring up different things, as well as a whistle button, because you need that. It's kind of feels a little bit more like Metal Gear Solid 5 in a way. It's also a mechanic where you can capture pictures, so it's kind of like Pokemon Snap in a way, and kind of have a gallery of different enemies. So I've been since I got that, I've been kind of trying to get a picture of every single enemy, so that's a new one for me.
Does that give you any sort of bonus in the game?
I have no idea. I just want to fill in this gallery. It's the Hyrule Compendium, so you can kind of see all the monsters. So we can even see that there's about 161 monsters unique in this game. So, I mean, besides that, there's like stuff for recipes and all that other stuff you can fill in. We're going to actually teleport. We have to open up the map for that. And we're going to go, let's see. Just want to make sure. Let's go by a stable. I know this area. We're going to actually go find a horse now. because the horse mechanics are a little bit different, because you don't just get a horse mm-hmm. and it immediately, you know, knows who you are and stuff like that. You can actually tame wild horses, but in order to do that, you need to calm them down so they're not, like, you know, freaking out that
gotcha.
You're, you know, just grabbing onto a random horse and, you know, shooting off for a mountain. So it'll look like I'm doing really poorly as far as controlling this horse, mm-hmm. but that's actually the horse fighting me in order to not want to be tamed. So let's try
that's a pretty cool mechanic they would add to the game.
Okay, we're really, really close to an area that has horses then. Okay. So this is actually one of the smaller areas that has a shop that we can go through. But money in this game does not drop from enemies at all. So the stuff that you collect that you can craft with can also be used to, you know, be sold for, you know, rupees. And then you use those rupees to buy, you know, various things from other people. And sometimes people walking around are actually merchants too. So you'll randomly find them while you're, you know, on a hillside. Okay, actually I wanted to find this horse specifically. So I've been finding that this blue horse is probably the best horse in the area. So let's try to get him. So there's a crouch here. I'm gonna try and mount this. I'm gonna rapidly hit this L button. Okay, there we go. So this horse, I like him because he's gonna have, I think, four. Yep. So we're gonna he's actually moving by himself. So I'm sort of steering him, but Link really has to make sure that this horse, you know, understands him. So you've gotta like mash that L button to soothe him. I just saw something fly up in the air for some reason.
Yeah,
it's a bird. Okay. I thought it was something else. But you can also see like the environment right now. It looks like it's about to rain. This is actually completely random too. So unlike other Zelda games where you have to like play a song in order to get it to rain for a few seconds for a puzzle, this is kind of just, you know, more realistic in a way. I mean, it's still Zelda, so you still have your fantasy stuff, but it's still, you know, a completely different game than most.
Alright, that's all the time we have for gameplay footage today. Thank you, Cody, for bringing in your game.
No problem.
And we will be back in a bit with our final thoughts.
Turn us on. Flip them off. 91.7. WSUW, the 91.7 is a student-run radio station serving the Whitewater area with a variety of original programs, live sports broadcasting, community events, and more. So turn us on.
91.7 FM.
Or stream us live at 917theedge.com.
The James R. Conner University Center on UW-Whitewater's campus is a gathering place for students of various cultures, backgrounds, and lifestyles. The UC is a great source for information, campus tickets, meetings, entertainment, food, gallery exhibits, workshops, and all of your hot card needs. Whether you're looking for a place to study between classes or just a place to hang out with friends, the UC is the place for you. For more information on the UC, please visit uc.uww.edu or go to facebook.com/uc.uww.
The University Health and Counseling Center has everything you need to reduce stress, tension, and muscle aches through their massage therapy services. Massage therapy is an all-natural way to promote healthy body functioning, relaxation, and to relieve aches and pains. The Health Center offers a variety of budget-friendly table and chair massages ranging from 15 to 75 minutes long. Massage therapy has something to offer everyone, so call today to make an appointment or go online for more information.
Peace, education, activism, through creative engagement. Peace is a nonpartisan organization that promotes peaceful resolutions to university and worldwide conflicts. We raise awareness on issues regarding environmental rights, social equality, and political justice. Every month, we show a documentary in the summer's auditorium. You can learn and have fun doing it. Peace, be the change you see in the world.
Welcome back to Double Jump Gaming News. And since Sabina, I didn't get to get my hands on Nintendo Switch for the unboxing, what were your first impressions on it?
I loved it. I was so excited. Actually getting the chance to play with David's Switch made me so excited to get my hands on my own Switch. I really loved how it felt. The controllers just feel really nice in your hands. The buttons, I am a stickler for buttons that actually press down. It felt nice. It felt smooth. I'm just raving about it. I actually really liked how compact it was. I thought it was going to be a little bit bigger when I first, like, saw it out in, like, in the trailers and such, but actually seeing it be like that size a little bit bigger than a 3DS XL, it's perfect. I think it's great for someone who just wants to throw it in their bag, take it to school, just bring it with you. Nintendo did a great job of actually capturing the essence of console at home, but also a console on the go. I'm honestly, I cannot wait to get my own copy or just my own physical console, because it's gonna be everywhere with me. Like, I'm just going to get bombarded at school. People are going to be like, hey, is that the Switch? Is that the Switch? Can I have it? And I'm like, no, it's mine. Oh, my goodness. So, since I am a big Legend of Zelda fan, I wanted to stay spoiler-free from Zelda. I didn't want to see anything for Breath of the Wild. I wanted to be completely clean. But, Justin, you actually got to play Breath of the Wild. What were your first impressions of it?
First impressions were overall very nice. One thing I know I was worried about with the Nintendo Switch was that previous Nintendo consoles, like the Wii, they wasn't really up to standards with, like, per se, the PS3 and the Xbox 360. So I was kind of afraid that the Switch wouldn't be up to par with, like, the PS4 and the Xbox One. But overall, I was really impressed with how it came, like, the graphics-wise, everything. Game ran really nicely. It seemed to be really smooth. I don't know if it was quite 60 frames per second, per se, but it was smooth enough to where it didn't look bad. Mm-hmm. And another thing I was really impressed about was the open world of the game. It was very, you know, reminiscent of, I would say, Skyrim almost, with how open it was. You can go anywhere you want to do. I know whoever was playing was fighting these weird little goblin things. I think were they goblins?
Yeah, they're the goblins.
Okay, goblins. Just making sure. I'm not a big Zelda fan. they looked, like, almost cartoony. The game was a really cartoony feel to it. I liked the feel of that a lot. And overall, I was just really, really impressed with it, I have to say.
So besides from the big launch title, like Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, we want to talk about some of the other games that either could be releasing soon or are just going to be released that weren't as big. Games such as the Binding of Isaac game that's coming out. I'm super excited for it. ARMS, which I know everyone's really hyped up about. Are there any games that you see coming to the Switch that just look pretty cool?
I know they're talking about, I'm not sure this is confirmed yet, but they're talking about Skyrim maybe coming out for the Switch. I think it'd be really nice benchmark to see how well the Switch can run a higher-end game like Skyrim or whatnot. Mm-hmm. And then me personally, I would love to see a Metroid game. Please, Metroid, anytime soon. Please, Nintendo, make it happen.
I think the Switch would actually be pretty good for a Metroid game. I think it'd be interesting, especially for people who want to, like, bring it on the go.
Well, definitely.
Oh, my goodness. That would be awesome. Especially because you'd have, like, the controllers and you can, like, actually pretend, like, you're shooting the things.
I'd like a remake of, like, an HD remake of, like, Super Metroid, original Metroid. And we need another Metroidvania-style Metroid game. Mm. It's been a while.
I'm actually really excited to download a bunch of, like, the older games. Like, I know they're allowing a bunch of, like, old Pokemon games to, like, you can get them from the store and stuff. I might be downloading some of the older ones just to replay them. I think it'd be really fun. Yeah, and The Binding of Isaac. Like, I have it on Steam, but to be able to bring it with me places, I think that'd be really enjoyable. Mm-hmm. I'd like it a lot. ARMS. Oh, my goodness. Have you seen what they've done for ARMS?
I saw a little bit. It looks like a fun excuse to just punch your friends. I have no excuse for it, or no complaints.
Yeah, I agree with that. All right. Well, we want to give a big thank you to David Jarris today for letting him bring in the Switch and letting us unbox it. Oh, it was so great. Thank you so much. So be sure to check out DoubleJumpGamingNews.com for more updates on the Nintendo Switch, including any system updates and game reviews. See you next week when we talk about Tom Clancy's Ghost Recon.